Welcome everyone to the new year, to 2020. I hope you have had a great start already. I cannot believe it's already the end of January. We have school going back next Tuesday for us in Australia. This is January or February is the start of the school year. And we have our middle girl, Sadie, starting school. So it's a big week next week. But I've got a quiet house at the moment. Everyone is out. So I wanted to jump in and say hi to you all. I'm just going to try and refresh my memory as to how I view comments and things like that. If anyone wants to jump on and share a comment and say hi so I can see if they pop up, that would be great. As I'm learning or relearning about Facebook Lives. It's been a while since I've done this. I'm flicking over. If anyone wants to jump on and say hi, and I'm happy to answer any questions while I'm on here today. But I wanted to talk to you about something. I'm getting lots of questions from people who have perhaps already started their business or are just about to start their personal concierge business. Lots of questions about pricing and websites and names and services and suppliers and forms. Lots and lots of questions. But there's always one thing, and you might be seeing it as a familiar comment throughout some of our posts recently, but there's one thing I always recommend that people do. And that is to really think about what your dream business looks like and how you want to operate, how many hours you want to work, what size business you ideally want. It doesn't have to be huge. It could just be you. You may just want to work a few hours during the day. You may want to only work 3 days a week, but you're happy to do longer hours. You may only be available out of hours on weekends. You may have plans to take over the world. Whatever it is, I suggest that you look at what your dream business is and who your dream clients are, who your ideal clients are that you want to service. This is really important because it helps you make all those other decisions. It helps you decide what pricing to set. It helps you decide what to name your business. It helps you to decide what look and feel you want for your logo and your website and your Facebook page. So then I often get, so I say, okay, who is your ideal client? And so people will come back to me and say, busy professionals and single mums and elderly clients. And so my first response is, you've got to narrow that down. You've got to pick one of those groups. And I want to give an example. If you were trying to market and put a message on your website or out on your Facebook page about the services you offer, what would you write in a post that is directed at seniors versus a post that is directed at single mums? They would be completely different, or they should be. So if you're trying to market to busy professionals and single mums and seniors, your message is going to get very wishy-washy. It's not going to be clear. There's not going to be any clarity around it. So you really need to narrow down and pick one group. And so if it was professionals, busy professionals, and I've just been messaging a few different people about this. If it's busy professionals, who are you actually going to be working for? You've got to narrow it down even further. So is it going to be a busy professional couple, busy professional single people, busy professional divorced people? Do they have children? What age group are the children in? What is their income bracket? Do they travel a lot? Where do they live? If it's a family or couple, are they both working? Are they both working full time? And then you really need to narrow down, if it's a husband and wife, who are you talking to, the husband or the wife? Because the messaging is going to be quite different in that situation. It all comes down to who is making those key decisions about juggling everything at home. And also, it'll then help you decide what you're going to be talking about. So, for example, my ideal client has been for a long time busy professional women. Now, that doesn't mean that they are, all of our clients are busy professional women. In fact, I'm noticing quite a change to having a lot more busy professional men use our services. And that is quite a change since I started 16 years ago. So I'm observing that and seeing if potentially our marketing message will change. But at the moment, we focus on busy professional women. And when I narrow it down to who I'm really targeting, it is generally busy professional women with children in primary school or still in primary school, but not usually with little children, because often the mum is still at home. So it's usually people where the husband and wife are both working. They've usually got primary school age children. They mostly run their own businesses. And the reason that that is the case is because they are used to delegating work out and getting people to do work for them and to entrust things to other people. So that is why we narrow it down to not just busy professional women, but busy professional women with primary school age children who are usually married, usually running their own business. So if I focus on that, my messaging is going to be very different to if I was trying to broadly target busy professionals of any aspect. And that could mean busy professional singles, busy professional men, divorced people. It would change dramatically. But because I am specifically focusing on busy professional women who are usually married with primary school age children and run their own business, that messaging can be quite clear for them. Now, people always worry, oh, if I narrow it right down to that, they won't feel inclined to use us. And first of all, if they're not your ideal client, you don't want to work for them anyway, because that makes your life harder. They may be difficult to work for, or it may mean that you're having to do a lot of different things that just doesn't fit with who you are, the type of business you want to offer. But that being said, if people are still resonating with who you are and what your business offers and the services that you offer, then people are still going to come to you. People are going to hear about you from your clients. They are going to understand that they can still use your services. You don't want to write on there, "We only service busy professional women, no one else please call." That's not how you do it, unless you ultimately want to do that. There may be people that only want to work with divorced men, and that is it. You can be clear, but you don't have to say, "We will not work with anyone else." That is not the intention, but it's about getting a lot of clarity around your message, because it makes it a lot easier for your ideal client to understand what you do, how you can help solve their problems, how you're going to make them feel when they use you. That's really important. And it makes your decisions a lot easier. Just imagine what your website will look like, or your Facebook page, or your Instagram account. Imagine what type of logo you'll design. Imagine what type of name you'll choose. Imagine what type of language you'll use in your e-newsletters, in your blog posts, in your Facebook posts. So I really want to leave you with a strong message today that I want you to really think about your ideal client. And this is something that's really important when you start your business, but it's equally as important to continually review this and update it and reassess, because things change. The best part about running this business is you learn so much as you go. So it's better to dive in and start running your business with a focus on really getting to know who your ideal client is and what they like and don't like. So it's a continual process. As I said, we'll probably be reviewing that even further this year, because the dynamics of things seem to be changing, at least for us in our city, for our business. But I want you to all, no matter what stage of your business you're at, think about your ideal client. Ask yourself, are you setting your ideal client too broadly? Are you trying to talk to too many people? Because that will confuse everyone and dilute the message. Now, I know there's a few people watching. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. I'm trying to work out if I can read comments, and I cannot see any at the moment. So if anyone wants to just even say a hi to help me out. But love you to ask any questions that you've got. Pop a comment down below. I'm going to try and do a lot more of these live videos inside the group. So feel free to let me know if you've got any questions you'd like me to answer. A lot of the topics I'm going to be talking about is about starting your business, how to launch, at what point should you be launching your business, and all the things that you need to do to make that happen. But I'm happy to answer any questions for people at any stage of their business. Now, I cannot see any comments on here. So if anyone has asked questions that I cannot see, and I'll go back and learn a bit more about how these comments work, but I'll go back and write a reply to you underneath if you've left comments. And anyone watching this video later on, please leave a comment below and I'll absolutely respond. And as I have been suggesting and a lot of you have been doing, please feel free at any time to send me a private message and I will get back to you as soon as I can, and I'll respond and happy to answer any questions you've got. So thank you for joining me, those who've popped on live today. Thank you for those of you who've watched later, and feel free to add comments. As I said, I'm going to try and jump on here a lot more this year. It all revolves around children at school and when our 16-month-old is asleep. So I'll do my best, but in the meantime, send me a question, drop a comment, and I'll be happy to help. But I hope you've all had a fantastic week. You've got a great weekend planned. We've got a long weekend here in Australia. And then it's back to school next week. So great to see you all, and I look forward to chatting to you again next week.